We have five easy, simple videos so you can stand out as a top real estate agent in your area.
Today on the Wandering But Not Lost podcast.
Welcome to the WBNL podcast, your online source for finding balance, where you can align, connect, and prosper. And now your hosts, Jan O'Brien and Matt Emerson.
Well, welcome to the Wandering But Not Lost podcast, where real estate and reality meet. This is episode 175. You can find all of our show notes over at WBNLpodcast.com. Jan O'Brien, we're talking video today. Something that is near and dear to our hearts right now, isn't it?
Well, you know, I figured if we just keep on talking about video, eventually some of our listeners and dear followers will realize that I could do this video. So today, it's nothing about YouTube. This is just five simple video ideas that I think can really convert clients, could impress people that you already know in your sphere of influence. They're easy to do. It'll get you playing a little bit more with video. And honestly, everything can be done 100% with your phone, with your mobile phone, right? So these are stand out with these video ideas, these five video ideas. You really can stand out, okay? And so let's just dive in, Matt, and we'll...
You're listening to the WBNL podcast. Subscribe and give us a review on any of your favorite podcast platforms. And don't forget to visit us at WBNLcoaching.com, where you'll gain access to all of our online courses and real estate agent freebies. We're always adding new materials, so subscribe to our newsletter and stay ahead of the game.
We're going to cover the five, and I'm going to share with you something that I use. We're going to demonstrate Loom, the Chrome extension Loom, which is free. I use it every single month. It's how I record my, right now I'm recording my market updates, which is one of the ideas. Okay, so super easy, total free. You just got to get out and get in front of the camera and not be afraid.
Okay? And it looks good too. You'll see in a minute when she demos,
yeah,
but it's cool.
It's not bad at all, right?
No.
So, all right, so let's go with the first one. And this is a real must because you need to have an intro or an about me video, just a simple 1 to 2 minute video. You could record it with your phone, get a little tripod or stand it up or something, and just don't, you know, don't be, you could even hold it if you wanted to or put it on a selfie stick, but have a simple video. And all these videos, if you're depending on how you're going to use them, they can be, if they're going to go like this one needs to go in your profiles like Zillow, there's a place for you to put a profile video for ZillowRealtor.com. Obviously, it should go on your website. This could be something that you send to people initially about yourself. So this just needs to be, who are you? Why should somebody work with you? What services do you provide? Are you a, is there a specialty that you have? So just your personality needs to shine through a little bit, right? Any recommendations on that, Matt? Like, what would you say just if somebody, if you, what would impress you if you went to somebody's website and you don't want some big long thing, but what should, concisely, what should we tell them that should be in their intro?
Yeah, I think you've hit all of it already, really, Jan. It needs to be short and concise. It needs to be genuine and authentic. I think that's really the key. And you can really overthink this because Jan and I write scripts all the time. And I think sometimes we overthink the script, right? Just let it flow naturally from you. You need to be yourself in this. And that is the key to the whole thing. So, you know, this should be a one taker. Right. Just get in there and just be yourself. Talk about what you want to do, what the passion is that brings you to real estate and what's going to bring you or what's in it for them. Right. What you're going to provide for the client, you know, regarding your communication style, how you're going to listen to them, blah, blah, blah. But it's all about being authentic.
I kind of feel like I haven't ever done this, nor will I probably. It's like what you might put on a dating site or something to say, if you have 1 minute to tell somebody who you are and for that to shine through and why should they call you? That's what we're talking about here, because you do want to find some, you do want to connect with people in some way. So why do you love real estate? You know, what is the client, why should the client reach out and talk to you, the person that wants to become your client? And I think there's nothing wrong with putting a little personalization in there. No. Like when you're not working with buyers and sellers and helping them find their homes, you enjoy going to the national parks, or your passion is X, Y, or Z. Now, why is that important? Because I really do think there's only so many people you can work with, and you might as well work with people who are going to enjoy the same kind of things you enjoy.
I was going to say, we talk about niche marketing a lot, and this is your way to say what your niches are without actually coming out and saying, hey, these are my niches. So absolutely.
All right. So this one is something is on my list to do because I've just got started out here and I need to go ahead and create this one. So check back or go to, you know, within the next couple of weeks, I need to make a commitment publicly right now that I'm going to go ahead and record this video for my livinginnorthtampa.com website.
Hey, we need it for WBNL coaching too. So next week when you and
Colin are
together,
we need to work
on that when we're all together in Vegas next week.
Hello, we're going to be doing two of those. So if you want to check back, you can come. We'll talk about it in our upcoming podcast and you can see examples of the intro video. Okay, so that's number one. What's number two? What did I say was number two? Oh yeah, I love this idea. This is such a great idea. We have talked about this, but I want to bring it back again because if you check out our last episode in 174, I talked about sellers have options, and I think the inventory is picking up. We're coming to the end of July as we record this, which means the moratoriums are being lifted. This is when I project in the next 60 days, we're going to see more inventory coming on the market. Why not right now? Go do a video market analysis. Now, this is how easy this is. You just literally, I'm going to show you how to use it, how to do it in Loom, the LOOM. If you're not already using this, if you're a Chrome user, get this extension. It is awesome. You can do videos up to 5 minutes long free. I upgraded to the annual thing, which is less than, I don't even know, maybe $50, $60 a year that allowed me to have longer than 5 minute videos. But I think you get everything you need that we're going to talk about today using the free extension.
Sure.
But you can just simply go into the MLS and record yourself. I'm going to demo this in just a minute and kind of show you what I'm talking about. You can go in, or you can, if you're listening, you can go over to the YouTube channel and you'll be able to watch the video later where I'm going to demo how to use Loom and how easy it is to record a housing report. And also, I think I'll just prompt to go in and show you what I mean by going in recording an a market analysis. So if Matt's my client, I want to just knock out two or three of these a day right now. Talk about standing out. Instead of sending an email with just the here's your market analysis, yeah. What if you sent a video that said, hey, I took a few minutes, Matt. The market is heating up. It's been hot for sellers, but we're starting to get more inventory. If you've ever thought about selling your home, now's the time to do it before the market shifts. Here's what I think you could get for your house. And you just go literally in and record yourself doing a market analysis and going over the comps and showing them that.
It's so smart.
Super powerful. Then you could send a text, a quick video text that just said, hey, if you didn't catch the email, I've been doing an update for everyone because of the market being so hot. I recorded a video just to tell you what I think your home is worth. If you'd been thinking of selling, even if you didn't, just so you know what your home's worth, how much equity you have at the moment. Okay. So that is number two, the video CMA. Speaking of, number three is doing exactly that. So it's just using video. So number three is to get used to using video to respond to leads, to follow up with somebody you haven't talked to in a while, and just record a quick video text. I mean, in a text, you could do a video or you could attach it in an email and use your phone and simply just, you know, you can also use Loom to do the email, which is really cool because you can create a little animated GIF where it looks like it's the video and you put that image in there and then they click on it and they go to your Loom and they get the video that you recorded for them. I used to use BombBomb and, you know, $500-$600 a year for BombBomb. You could do the same thing with Loom for free, right?
Yep.
So a video text is using something like Loom or video email, but just use your phone. Now there is a little bit of weirdness that goes from like when you are using an Apple, an iPhone, and you're sending a video to an Android user, it's like tiny, you know, it's like really hard to see. So cross-platform or cross phone types, there can be some issues, but you can use something like Loom to do it. So stand out by following up your leads with a video where you introduce yourself or, hi, Matt, thanks for reaching out. You were interested in 123 Elm Street. I'd love to be able to connect with you so I can talk to you about what your goals are for real estate, something like that. Or if you haven't talked to your clients in a while, we talked about video CMAs. If they don't own a home, you could do other things, just checking in with them. Or here's a market update. I've talked about this so many times. You know, I just did the market update. It's on my blog. In case you missed it, here's a link to it. And you're just doing a video telling them to go take some action. If you've been thinking about what, you know, homes are, the market is shifting, or if you want to know more about looking for homes for sale, or have you thought about buying a new home? I have this great feature. You know, you have so many things that you can send to people. If you have another great idea would be, if you haven't already done so, share your MLS app. You know, We all have them. You all have some kind of a home search app that you get through your MLS or through your company. Share it with people. You know why? Because people, even if they're not thinking of buying or selling today, love looking at houses. They just do. So just go through your whole database and share your app with them. Do a quick video. Hey, Matt, it's Jen. I don't know if I ever shared this cool app with you because I find people love to look at houses. Here it is. Just click on it and you'll download it. And you can look up any house anytime you're driving around. And if you're interested, just give me a call and I'll find out about the house if it's available, et cetera. Right? Really easy. So easy. But this is how you can stand out. It's so easy just to do a quick video and people will be impressed that you took the time to do that. Goes without saying, doing birthday video emails or anniversaries. Congratulations, you've been in your home for 3 years. I did a market analysis and emailed it to you. Happy anniversary. Milestones that maybe you pick up from seeing them on social. A video is just the way to stand out. And we're just talking about a 30-second video, you know, not like creating a whole script and all the stuff that we do, right? So anything else you can think of on that one? I mean, it's easy. That one is just in the moment, spur of the moment.
Yeah, no, I think you covered it.
But also customizing it, knowing that you know, scheduling it because you got an idea around it. Hey, all right, let's look at number four.
The simple fact that you're even going to freaking do it makes you stand out, for crying out loud.
Whatever, just pick one of these five things, people, exactly. All right? You don't have to do all of them. All right, number four, this is my favorite just because I think it's gets you into the rhythm of having to study the market. And then it's the easiest thing that got me continually. Now I'm on like going on a year of doing these for the team, and I just started a whole new one. I did my first one for North Tampa, Matt.
Yep.
And I used the same thing I'm going to show everybody. So it's just your local market and or housing report. You could do this monthly. I really recommend recording a video with it. And I'm going to show you exactly right now how we do this. So we use Keeping Current Matters, and Matt's got a link there in the link in the show notes at WBNL Coaching. Go to the podcast or WBNLpodcast.com. We'll take you there. This is episode 175. You can get a link to the Chrome extension is in the show notes today. Plus a couple little things on how to create this animated GIF that I'm talking about that you can insert in an email, and it looks like the video, and people are going to be inclined to click on it, which is going to get them to watch your video if you send it in an email. It's a great little trick. And then check out Keeping Current Matters. I swear, $30 a month, I think it is.
Yep.
You can try it for free for 14 days. Trust me, you're going to use it. I have it hooked up. I have blog posts every day going up. I use their monthly market report that comes out on the 10th of every month and pull the slides down that I like. David Childers is the guy who records these, and he gives you the script. You can download his audio, his script, and use his language if you're not comfortable with it. And it tells you what to say to your clients. Okay.
It's super easy and super brilliant, right? I mean, they are so wonderful about getting information to you that you can use with your clients. I just love it. I mean, this is a really good example. If you're intimidated by putting that together, they've already done it for you.
Right? Oh my gosh. And it's incredible. Like, I don't take all of it. I pick ones that I like and I'm comfortable with. Then I add local housing information. I'll show that to you in just a moment and describe it to you if you're listening via the podcast. But I just can't tell you how important it is to just start somewhere. And maybe it's just this. You're going to start with a market report, because then what you can do is you can include it in your monthly newsletter, which
that's right.
Is exactly what we do. Number one. Number two, I make it a blog post, which I do.
Yep.
And then the blog post goes to, it can become a text that you send to say, hey, we just recorded the monthly market update and here's everything that the housing report. I'm going to demonstrate all that and show that to everybody here. Before we do that, let's go to number five. And then I'll kind of give everybody a quick walkthrough of how do you actually do it and an example of it. So the last one is testimonials, video testimonials of your clients. I think this is so powerful. And honestly, it's nothing more than when somebody is in the moment and you're maybe delivering some pizzas to their house or handing the keys over to them. See if they'd be willing to just do a quick testimonial in the moment, raw. Just what was the experience like? Ask them a couple of questions like you're interviewing them and see if they'll just do that for you and give you the permission to use that. Now you can put that on social. You can put it on your website. You know, there's just so much. Other people saying why that they should work with you is the key. It'd be great to get them to obviously go put that on Google. To me, everything's about Google right now, or Zillow or something, but get some video testimonials that really stands out. We got recently some video testimonials.
We did, and they're awesome.
Mm-hmm. And we really, truly enjoy that. So, all right, what I'm going to do here, let me make sure I can do this. I'm going to demonstrate and walk you through. If you're watching, obviously you can see it. Let me just share my screen. I have Loom open up, Matt. All I have
While Jan's getting that all ready, I want to invite you all to go over to WBNLcoaching.com. We have just rebranded our entire site. We have a couple of brand new courses up there. A bunch of awesome free stuff that you can download.
Oh, yeah.
That we want you to get over there and check that out. And then also, we really want to talk about our signature course, Real Estate Sales Builder. It's an incredible 12-module course, 119 lessons, bite-sized, digestible. Great stuff. Great information for a new agent. Great information for an agent that needs to get back in there and retool and build a stronger foundation so they can have a prosperous career. Just really, really good stuff over there. So go check it out over WBNLcoaching.com. Speaking of Real Estate Sales Builder, if you go to our show notes this week, we do have a special offer only for our podcast listeners. Go over to the show notes. That's where you're going to find the coupon code that will get you 50% off.
Awesome. 50% off?
That's right.
Okay, well, you heard it here from Matt himself. All right, so what I'm doing is I'm sharing right now for the listeners on the podcast my Chrome extension for Loom, loom.com. So in the show notes, frankly, just go to Google, type in Loom Chrome extension, install it like you would any other extension. And then there's a couple little tricks if you didn't know that you can pin all your extensions so you can quickly find them, you know, in your browser when you're in Chrome. And then it's as easy as hitting the Loom. It looks like a little purple, I don't know, spirograph. It kind of is the icon. And it's so simple to use. You click on it and you are able to record your screen, the screen with you. And, you know, and so that's what I do. So to make the market reports, I'm going to go through here to show you. So yeah, I've created folders. And so what I have right now, what I'm showing is I'll pull up my July market report for living in North Tampa, and it sits here. So it's like you don't have to go post this stuff up to YouTube or anything. It sits here in your Loom library. You can create a shared library if you want to. Now, what I'm doing, what I have done with Matt's help is we created the slides in Canva. Then what I do is I go to Canva. So right now when I was showing it, I had to clip that part out, right? So inside of Loom itself, there's a simple editor to trim the video in the front. Or, I mean, it's not like a super deluxe editor, but it's enough to cut out the beginning or the ending or anything else that you mess up. And so right from Loom, you can create the video. You can even trim it or fix it up a little bit if you want to. And then you can add a thumbnail. You can create this little animated GIF where, you know, like at the very beginning of your video, you can like wave or you can make some movement and it'll capture those first couple seconds. So that's what you could grab, download, and go put into an email like a video. And it's going to make it look like it's moving, right? It's the idea I always love with BombBomb, the animated GIF.
Right.
If you put inside of it a picture, that's all you do. And it links to your video that goes over to your Loom, and it just sits there. So it sits there, and you're able to, they can't see anything else unless you want them to see the other parts of your video. But it's awesome. So all I did was record my, in Canva, I presented, right? I turned on the Loom, and then I just had, there's three different size circles that you can use where you're in the picture. And now then I can move it where I want to. So I did that all as a setup. Then I started talking, right? And then I'm done. And now the video is done. It's a 8 to 10 minute video because I do a little bit longer one, but you don't need to do a long one. You can just do a 3 or 4 minute video. What's going on? And you're talking to people. They're seeing your little head. All right. And that's all there is to it. And then you can grab it. You can embed it. You can get the link to it. You can put it anywhere you want to. Now what I do, because I want this to be a YouTube video, is we have a YouTube channel, so we download it and I put it on YouTube, right? So that's the other thing that you can do with it. Super, super simple to use. I've also included in the show notes, like I said, a quick little tutorial on how to create the animated GIF so that you can, embed it into your emails and just use this. So forget about YouTube. These are just 5 simple ideas to start using video now. and with just your phone, and to get used to using video. And in some future episodes, we'll really talk, because we're really digging into the whole YouTube thing. Yes. And those staying committed to YouTube definitely takes a little bit more effort. But for those of you that want to do it, it can make a huge difference. And I think we'll have Cosmo come on and talk a little bit about that with us. Let's invite Cosmo to an upcoming episode to talk about what are his top tips to get started with YouTube, because he does have a course that he has created for how to be a YouTuber for real estate agents. And we'll, I'm sure, be offering a good deal on that as well. So we'll have him come in and talk about that for all of you who want to take video to the next level. But today, simple. Five simple ideas. Grab one or two of them and start today. Do not delay. Stop procrastinating about video. It can change things for you. I definitely think the things I shared with you today can help convert leads, convert people to continue to work with you, or maybe convince them that, oh, you're not that busy. I can work with you because you reached out to me and told me, you know, hello.
Yeah, right.
Right?
Exactly.
That's all I have, Mr. Matt. I just want to keep it simple today. Encourage people to use video. We're getting more comfortable with it. We'll share some ideas of the specific videos that Cosmos has the team in Vegas doing, and what I'm doing out here, and what kind of results we're getting. And maybe we'll even work on that next week. Okay.
Sounds like a plan. It was awesome to see you last week, Jan O'Brien, in the Sunshine State. Thank you very much. I had the opportunity to go visit Jan O'Brien and her stomping ground outside there in Wesley Chapel. And we had a great time, went to an awesome lunch, family-owned restaurant.
Yeah, it was so wonderful. Good.
What was the name of that again, the name of the restaurant?
It's called Via Italia.
Oh, my God. The food was so awesome. It was really
authentic Italian restaurant.
And then went to on a nice little hike, as long as we could probably stand it, before we melted away at Hillsborough State Park, which was freaking awesome and beautiful as well. I mean, it just looked like you were in the middle of the bayou. I love it. You know what I mean? The water is awesome. And then we did a little house kicking. Didn't go in any of the models, but Jan was showing me all the freaking new construction going on there at Wesley Chapel. Unbelievable how much new home construction's going on out there.
So if you know anybody moving to Florida, real estate pros, reach out to me. I can help you with any part of the Tampa area, and even throughout Florida. We have a bunch of realtors that we're connected with here in Florida. Can help you out, get your referral, take care of your client.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to your video.
If you've been to Florida,
on Windy Ridge.
Yeah, check out Living in North Tampa is my new channel. I actually have two videos up. One is the market report for July for this area, and two is the townhomes at River Landing that we just got completed. And check out, let's put those links in the notes so people can get an idea, because we are going to be talking about YouTube. We have our Living in Las Vegas and Henderson, which is our team in Vegas, and they're really starting to do great with their videos out there. So we're very excited about that. We're going to demonstrate that you can get business using YouTube. Plus, you can get our course, which we'll be unveiling next week. I think we're close to getting that within the next week or two over at WBNL Coaching, and I'll tell you all about that. So come on back next week. We're going to keep talking video for a little bit, I think, on our podcast, since we're all into it. Oh, we're going to be together soon, so maybe we'll do something out there. We're all going to be in Vegas. Hello. Right?
Exactly.
Maybe we'll do a live podcast out there when we're there.
That's a good idea. We should do that more.
If we have time, we can knock it out.
All right, guys. I guess that is a wrap for episode 175 of the Wandering But Not Lost podcast. You can get all of our show notes over at WBNLpodcast.com. And remember, everyone, get up, get out, stay safe. There's a evil Delta variant that seems to be creating a little havoc. So get with the program, people. And be forever wandering, but not lost.
Yes.